Hello everybody, welcome to Developing Success. As all of us know that the prelims examination 2020 have been postponed to the 4th of October 2020 and the mains examination will be starting from 8th of January 2021. So we have a lot of time left and in this video I am going to discuss about the 4-month extra strategy and how to utilize this extra time. So, as you know that the pillars of the preparation, the pillars of the preparation are the NCERT books, newspaper, answer writing, MCQ practice, optional paper. There are more pillars, we'll discuss them one by one. So, first of all, we will talk about the NCERT books. So, those who have not completed the NCERT books till now, they can complete it one by one or they can choose which NCERT they find important. As see, I am not telling you which is important and which is not, because you have already prepared for 1 year, and this video is for those students who are sitting for this attempt in 2020. So you must have by the time known and you must have by the time prepared well. So we are discussing that what you can do is some of the NCERTs which you have planned in the past that you will do but you did not get time, you can complete those NCERTs as well. Another thing is what we discuss is the newspaper. So by this time, all the aspirants, what they do, they actually depend on the current affair capsule. So the current affair capsule provided by different coaching institutes, different materials in the market, weekly, monthly and whatnot. But the main pillar for the current affair is the newspaper. Why to study is newspaper? We all know, because while you study the newspaper, fair understanding is built by you. But when you study the current affair capsule monthly, weekly, bi-fortnightly, whatnot, so then thing is developed in your mind which the maker of that magazine, which the maker of that material thinks. But when you read the newspaper, your own mind, your own analysis develops. And now you have a lot of time, so you can cultivate this habit again. So read the newspaper. This will be very beneficial, and that will also improve your comprehensive strategy towards the mains examination also. And while you read the newspaper, just select one article from the newspaper every day and write a summary of that article. Why I am saying this? Because when you write the summary of that article, you actually comprehend that article and you actually compress that article into some words. So suppose the article consists of 2000 words or 1000 words, so try to compress that particular article into 100 or 200 words, so that the mains answer writing is also practiced side by side. So this is a very important tool, newspaper. It will also develop your understanding of the current topics, and also you can practice the answer writing from it daily. Next is your MCQ practice. So as we know that the 4th of October is your exam, so for this month, for the June month actually, you can just leave the MCQ practice. But again, from July, August and September, you should at least do two papers in a week, at least two papers. So let me tell you, just solving the paper is not enough, okay? So just solving will not do. You have to analyze the paper. So until and unless you analyze the paper well, you find out your mistakes and you work upon that mistakes, that test will not solve the purpose. So the students who solve the paper and who just see the score and thinks that they have solved the paper, so that will improve their score, that is not going to happen. So you have to do the analysis of the whole paper, then only the whole thing is then the completed. While you solve the paper and analyze it, then only the whole process gets complete, okay? So next is your optional paper. So while you have a whole lot of time, so what you can do is we can use the whole June and July to build your optional. See, optional is a very important pillar to score very good. For example, the GS paper 1, 2, 3, 4, there is 250 marks. If you score two good in one GS paper, you can score 120 plus, okay? So if I multiply 120 by 4, that accounts to 480 marks. So when you study for four papers, when you give your best and when you assume that you will be getting 120 plus in all papers, which is not very possible case, you get around 480. But with just one optional paper, with just one subject, you can score 300 plus, and that can give you a great rank in the examination. So when you have got this extra time, June and July, so if you are finding it monotonous, or if you are finding it very boring, you can divide your day into two parts. So one part of the day give to the optional paper, and another part of the day give to your prelims and newspaper and your CSAT strategy. Okay, CSAT, and your also if you want to study some GS mains paper, or if you want to solve some paper, or if you want to go for some particular NCRT as we discussed. So you can do all of the things in half of the day, and another half you can utilize for optional. So full June and July, we can have a good command over the optional. So we are taking both this month. Don't take it that the 2 months are more than enough and they are sufficient. No, if you utilize the half day, that is not enough. Okay, you have to take 2 months for making a command over the subject, not just reading and writing, for making a good command, so that just after the prelim gets over, you can focus on the GS mains paper, like the ethics paper, like the other GS mains paper 1, 2, 3. Okay, you will have a command over the optional subject that will give you an edge in your scoring. Now the next thing is optional subject. Again, I am telling you that the studying of the optional is not complete until and unless you write answers. So the students ask, so from where should we take up the question? Very simple answer, you should take previous year's paper. Listen, the previous year questions will never be repeated, but the topics are very limited. Okay, so the topics are generally repeated. The same question can be asked in a different manner. So if you practice the previous year's papers, like the past 5 years should be practiced at least 2 times. Okay, first time you write an answer, second time you write an answer, if you don't find any improvement, you can self-judge it, because it's a whole year you have been preparing. And if you don't find anything impressive or any addition to the answer, then there is a worrisome situation. So the optional preparation is also not complete if you don't write answer. So if you are studying 4 hours in a day for the optional paper, keep at least half an hour for your one answer, and also to analyze it. At least write one answer daily, okay, in June, and try to write 2 answers daily in the month of July. Okay, so that will give you a great edge in the subject, a great command in the subject. Another thing is that this NCRT books, newspaper, answer writing, MCQ practice, and optional paper, keep the pace up, and when the month of August comes, you can again take up some subject which you find is important for your prelims examination, and which you also think that it needs a separate revision, and because of the extra time you got, you can make a command. See, the important subjects, as we all know, is your polity, is history, is environment, is economics and geography. So choose among this subject that which subject needs a special one revision again. So choose that subject in August, and then in the month of August and September, continue your newspaper and answer writing. And 4th of October is your exam. So from 15th of September, you can stop reading the newspaper and stop the mains preparation and whatever you were doing. And you can completely focus these last 20 days upon your prelims. So the whole 4 months, don't take the whole 4 months to again revise the prelims syllabus and again go through that monotonous thing. Try to think about the mains answer writing and try to complete your optional fully. Try to make a command. Try to utilize this 4 months to make your optional very nice, so that when the prelims gets over in the month of October, and then you get November and December, and January is barely there, So there are mainly October also you have some 25 days. So these 3 months will be deciding. And let me tell you, these October and November months, these are full of, you know, celebrations like Navratri and Durga Puja and Diwali and whatnot. So in this October and November month, and the Chhat Puja also is there, Eid is also there, okay? So in this October and November month, 10 days are wasted for every aspirant. How much serious you are, I don't mind. But if you are not celebrating, also the mind will be there. So these 10 days will be, destroyed because of this October and November time. So keep in mind that you have very less time during this mains. Okay. So that is why June and July, use it very beneficially for your mains preparation and also for your optional preparation. Apart from that, cultivate the habit of reading newspaper daily, and when you come to the July month, the newspaper daily should be completed in 40 minutes. Okay, don't read the juicy news and don't read the unnecessary. By this time I believe you must have known what to read and what not to read, and write one answer daily in the terms of newspaper summary, one article, and write one answer daily for the optional subject. So you are writing two answers daily, you are preparing some of the newspapers that will update you in the terms of current affairs, and you are doing the optional subject. That is more than enough. Don't burden yourself too much, and don't be relaxed and lethargic also. Utilize the time very nicely, build yourself. And that is all for this strategy lecture. If you have any doubt, you can comment on the comment section, and those who are the students of Developing Success, they can personally message me on the WhatsApp group or on the Telegram group, and we can discuss it further. Thank you. All the best to all the students.